Ellie, New Mexico is one of the few states that has essentially no major restrictions on abortion. Women from more restrictive states, pregnant people from more restrictive states have long been coming here for abortion. This is likely to bring more of them. What is the impact going to be on New Mexico in terms of their access?
What we're seeing unfold right now is not only a constitutional crisis, but a public health crisis in the making. And so we all know this. Here in New Mexico, we have a general lack of access to healthcare, particularly in more rural parts of our state, and even more particularly when it comes to reproductive health. Look, I grew up in southern New Mexico, and it has always been a challenge to access the reproductive health that we need. And so as we look towards receiving folks from other states who need basic medical care, you know, what is going to happen is a stressed infrastructure. And already abortion providers have been providing care to people all across the country. They've extended their hours, they've hired more staff. We are experiencing an expansion of providers here in New Mexico. But what this means practically are longer wait times, not only for abortion care, but for other types of reproductive health care. Many abortion providers are full scope reproductive health care providers. And so as wait times increase, and you know, abortion is a particularly time sensitive type of healthcare, we are going to see a stressed infrastructure. And it's important to understand that the folks that are able to come here, for every person that is able to come here and get the healthcare that they need, they will have had to take time off of work, secure childcare, secure travel funds, get the appointment, pay for the procedure or medication. Thousands of people will not be able to access those resources. And so, yes, our infrastructure will be stressed, but we cannot lose sight of the fact that that it takes a certain level of resources and privilege to leave your home state to get healthcare. And many, many other people will be trapped in their home state, unable to access care that they need.
Thank you for that, Ellie Rushforth.
Thank you.